Namaskar, I'm Nandita Pandey back here again, and this is again for the coming weekly forecast from 15th of January to 21st of January 2017. And I wish you all a beautiful year ahead and a very, very happy new year. And I pray that a lot of good things happen in your life all through the year. This is also a beautiful time when most of the planets, in fact, all the planets are direct. So from 8th of January to 9th of February, this one full month of energy is loaded with positive powers, positive energies, positive growth. So that's the time I would want you all to just take up new projects, start acting on it and work towards it so that no more positive energies come to you and better results come to you. So go all out, do that. So that's the kind of phase I want you to go into. So that's the kind of energies I want you to play around with. Now coming back to the weekly forecast, because all the planets are direct, as I said, you need to take up at least even a small investment would bring you a lot of positive energies all through this week. Now, starting up with Aries, these forecasts are based on tarot. They're based on your sun signs. And we'll start up with Aries. On Aries, I see a lot of happiness in matters of heart. So you will all through the week, you will come across a lot of opportunities that will come through and boost your confidence as far as your love relationship is concerned. A lot of romance, peace, happiness, all for you. All through this week. Professionally also, I see the more you work, the more focused you are, the more energetic you are, the better the results are. Also, youngsters are going to help you out in your work area. Financially, expenses on women figures are extremely high. That's an area that you need to be careful about. So that's the kind of situation I see you undergoing. Health, it's a balance that you need to create. If you create a balance, things would be absolutely fine for you. Family-wise, again, feminine energy is helping you all through this week. And travels that you manifest in this week only indicates average success. There's nothing great happening, but then nothing bad either taking place for you all through this week. By the end of the week, the errands basically are kind of feeling, wanting to go out, spend time in open areas, beautiful parks, or maybe children park. Do go out to children park because that will give you a lot of peace, happiness, success in your life, and a lot of contentment will fall into your life. And the card that has come for Aries is a healing card. I would want you to focus on your physical self, your spiritual self, your mental body, all the five bodies that are there. You do focus on it, the etheric body. So take salt baths, go out and do some walks. Because there's another card again. The card again is talking about body healing. So you need to focus on your healing energies. So both the cards are trying to talk to you. Focus on your physical self. Take up a new exercise regime, follow some yoga patterns, or just go out, do some walks, brisk walks. It will be good for you. Follow that up. Let us see how Taurians are undergoing. And for Taurians, I see a lot of changes taking place for you. And when I look into Taurians, it says that anything that you knew you start in this week, especially when it comes down to your matters of heart, will bring in a lot of peace, happiness, love, romance. I see you celebrating beautifully with all your kith and kins all through this coming week, and a lot of positive energies falling all around for you in this time. Also, a fatherly figure, somebody very strong, someone who has a good communication skill and good positive energies will help you out in this week as far as your work is concerned. And the more action-oriented you are, you know, this is a week which demands a lot of action, quick decisions in your investments. When you do that, it sees good positive changes on Archangel Michael, because I have also opened up angel cards for you and says the guidance is coming that you are being protected in your financial area. So do take decisions there, and this is a beautiful card falling in which is trying to help you out, protect you in this particular area. Health also will be good. Outdoor activities are absolutely great for you. And women forces again for you also are the ones who would help you out, especially in your family matters. So all the women who are glib talkers in your family are the ones who are going to help you out in your endeavors in this week. if you're planning to or intending to travel, so you need to be a little more patient, a little more diplomatic. And if you do so, then situations will be extremely positive for you in this week. From bad times to good times, that's a kind of movement that I see for you. So a lot of changes happening, which would also manifest in times to come. For Geminis, again a good period, and Mercury being the lord of your sign is now bringing in a lot of positivity for you the whole week through. So there are new communications taking shape, new PR skills that are happening, also new gadgets being bought. Matches of heart are peaceful, good, contentment is foreseen in this front. You would want more out of your relationship in this whole week through. Your juniors are going to help you out in your work front, and good news also knocking your door in that area. Financially, again, an elderly person, someone who has very strong communication skills and somebody who has reached a position of strength because of his efforts and his wisdom and his hard work is the one who would want to help you out. Manifestations is the card for you. That means whatever you desire in this week, whatever you work towards in this week is going to manifest for you, Gemini. So, however, health of a fatherly figure needs to be taken care of in this week. And also, I foresee that travels are best avoided. And by the end of the week, especially around 20th and 21st of the month, you need to be very, very careful because there are possibilities of having differences or ego clashes with somebody close to you, or a partnership issue or a property issue might suddenly pop up and crop up. So be careful about that. Let us see how Cancerian is going to do. And for Cancerian, positive changes in matters of heart. A lot of beautiful contentment flowing in here, seeping in. It's like showering. All the energies are downpouring on you. You would know how to manipulate situations to your favor and turn even the difficult situation status in your favor in this week, especially in matters of heart. Professionally, communication is the key to growth. You need to work towards that. That means you need to be less stubborn, more flexible in your approach, and the more you are, the better the results would fall into. Financially, subtle changes happening as I see the whole week through. Health is absolutely good and powerful changes. Travels make only if you are kind of very, very positive about it. Otherwise, they're best avoided. In family life also, I see there are a lot of promises that would be made to you, but they're being fulfilled. Can be a bone of contention. So that's not happening in this week. So if you want that to take place and happen, then you would need to act with conviction, with backup support system, with the alternative methods also to make sure that that happens. And the guidance for you coming this week is new beginnings for Cancerians. So if you planned or you're planning to start up a new project, you're planning to look into a new health regime, this is a good time to start up this thing, or maybe a new investment would be a good thing for you to do. Also, apart from that, in relationship area, maybe you need to have just a very, very fresh outlook and approach towards it. That might bring you a lot of happiness and success. Leos, I see financially it's a beautiful time for you. Legal matters are going to turn in your favor. There would be a lot of happiness that are happening right now, and your credits are being given, investments are favoring you. Professionally, creative projects are going to give you a boost. You would be emotionally happy in your work front. Matters of heart, I just see a very, very average time frame around this time. Nothing great happening in this front, and you would need to follow your gut instincts and intuitive streaks in order to bring back the romance that you so desire. So health is an area that you have to be extremely careful about. Cold, cough, fever, you can be an easy target in that area. Family life improves a lot because you've made a lot of effort in this front. Travels, if you're intending to, would be good. There could be positive changes in your travel front. You might undergo a lot of shopping while traveling. So keep a check on that. You and the card that comes up to you is the forgiveness card. It is talking about you need to let go of any resentments that have you kept and stored in your heart. Release it right now. That's not the time for you to hold on to it. and let us see how Virgos are doing. So for Virgos, lot of good growth patterns taking shape now, and I see new beginnings and with a fresh approach. If you start up your investments, it will be very, very positive time for you to take up new investments around this time, and also follow your intuitive guidance as far as your projects are concerned. So the more you follow your intuition, the better the results would turn out to be. Also in matters of heart, it's a lot of emotional contentment and happiness that seeps in this week as the week progresses. From now onwards, a lot of situations will start improving up for you. Health-wise, it's an abdominal area is an area of concern. But by the end of the week, I see a youngster could turn out to be very, very demanding. For you, the card that comes out is to look out for signs. So there could be signs, situations, symbols or messages coming in. Try to connect to your guardian angels. Try to connect to your divine angels. Try to look into messages either via the music or maybe a number pattern repeating. Something that would be an answer to your call that might give you the exact answer to what you're seeking. So do that. This is the time for you to do that and you will be way, way better off. And let us see how Librans are doing. And for Librans, I see financially you being stuck up in the sense that you are too possessive. You're holding on to your investments. This is not the time to hold on to your investments. Just release them. Do a charity, you know, work into that area. If you do that, then things will start flowing in for you and more downpouring would come. And any new health activity that you start during this time is going to give you a lot of positive changes. Professionally, you need to act with very, very practical approach in life. If you do that, you are going to rock. Otherwise, there could be problems. Matters of heart overall are good, yet there is a sense of not getting enough. Family-wise, a woman can be a cause of concern the whole week through. Travels are very restricted. I don't see a very free-flowing freedom in your travel. So they're best avoided in this week. Try going out, spending time in children's park or in the company of children. It'll really be soothing and good for you. And the message that comes to you is again, as I said, it's a repeat of children. That means you need to spend time with children, enjoy their energies, be positive. Invoke your inner child, and the more you connect with your inner child, the better the situations would be for you. And for Scorpio, I see there has been a lot of tough times off late as far as your love relationship is concerned. But this is a week when all your efforts are going to fructify and bring you a lot of blessings, peace, romance and love in your life. So beautiful harmonious energies coming in here. Professionally also, whatever efforts you have made in this week are going to bring you positive changes, positive growth. There's a lot of blessings coming in this end, but you need to be very practical in your approach. If you do that, it'll be good for you. Financially, it's an expensive week and expenses on a fatherly figure is expected in this week. Health-wise, minor abdominal troubles can trouble you the whole week through. Also, I see youngsters in the family are being very demanding on you all through the week. And good news via travels. If you're planning to have travels, please go ahead. It's a good time for you to go ahead with it. And by the end of the week, I see somebody who is like a fatherly figure, who's financially very sound, helping you out in your life. And for you, the cards that come out and the guidance that come out again is forgiveness, which means that you need to let go of a lot of deadlocks in your life. There are a lot of energies which are being stuck up and you are unable to sail through it. You're grieving in it. You need to forgive. You need to forgive yourself and just let go of and surrender to divine sources and divine energies, and you will be in a much, much better status. Now for Sagittarius, I see good growth opportunities coming up in the work area. So the more focused you are, the better the energies are for you. Professionally, the more you travel, the better situations would turn out to be. And then the second that I see, especially for Sagittarians, is beautiful romantic week. A lot of happiness coming in this front. And you are your witty self and your energetic self. And you take actions and believe in it. And love and romance all flows down on you. Financially, again, a positive time, good growth factors coming up, and a woman who has got, who probably is a CA or a banker or somebody who has a good financial knack is the one you need to talk to, because she's the one who's going to help you out in enhancing your monetary strengths. Health-wise, a lot of good changes happening in this front, and situations will be extremely positive, but you will have to be very, very patient while dealing with your health. Family matters bring in a lot of love and happiness and peace. Travels are very favorable, but by the end of the week, you might feel a little let down or might feel that you're not being given as importance as that you want to. The first card talks about retreat. That means you need to look within yourself, maybe give time to yourself, do a lot of inner contemplations, or take a spa, or spend some quiet time yourself. And if you do that, it'll be really, really healing for you and will bring you a lot of changes. And the second card was about the cards about dreams, and it says that a lot of messages will come to you via your dreams that you need to interpret and follow, because angels and guardian angels and divine angels and supreme God are going to connect. They're waiting to connect to you through your dreams and give you messages, and yet you're not opening up to them. Do that and you will be way, way happy that you did that. So for Capricorns, I see you extremely busy in your work front. You are unable to even give time to yourself. So that's a kind of deadlock I see you undergoing. But then again, good growth. Focus on team efforts and you'll do way better in your work area. Investments. Any restless, immediate decisions regarding your finances can bring you disappointments. So be careful on that front. Health should be good. And if you create a balance in your family life, things will manifest in the positive. Your partner is going to be very demanding in your romantic life. So situations, circumstances being overpowering on you. This is the kind of pattern that I see you entering the whole week through. Travels are just about average. Nothing great happening here, but nothing bad also. By the end of the week, the more creative you are, the more rejuvenated you feel, or more you start afresh and learn new skills, the better your state would be. And again, as I said, guardian angels. So the card says your guardian angels are ready to speak to you and you are unable to trap the energies. You're not doing that. You need to do that this week. And if you do that this week, whatever blockages you have in your life will just go away like this. So follow that up. For Aquarians, I see matters of hearts are pretty romantic, but initially, in the beginning of the week, you might feel a little deadlock here in this aspect and might feel that things are not really working, or might be a little insecure about whether you should take up this action or not. So don't be insecure. Just go ahead with it and you will find a lot of happiness coming here. Financially, it's a good time again for you. I see you investing money on shopping spree, or there could be some renovation at home or redecorating house, something like that, that I see the money would go out onto. Otherwise, it's a good time for you to enhance and strengthen your monetary area. Professionally, if you don't like a thing, please say no to it. Then you'll be in a better off situation. Health-wise, it's an average week for you. Family life is beautiful. You would love to be in the company of your friends and family. There's something very positive taking place here for you. Some union or some happiness, some celebration taking place here. Somebody who's like a motherly figure can help you out in your travel ventures. This is a beautiful time to manifest good positive energies. But by the end of the week, there could be a news which might disappoint you, or maybe a child might turn out to be too demanding. You need to create intentions to achieve success in your life. If you do that, and do that with very strong focus, that will manifest in your life. There's a sign card, which again is talking about follow the signs. Look out for your guardian angels. Look out for the repeated numbers. Look out for angel messages. Look out for messages through music or text messages. Something somewhere your guardian angels are connecting and they're wanting to tell you. You are unable to trap that energies. You need to trap those energies now. And last but not the least, we look into Pisceans and see how they are doing in their life. For Pisceans, I see old romantic endeavors taking shape. That could mean that you might hear from your ex-flame, or might hear of something about your earlier relationships in this week. But even the present relationship showers a lot of attention on you. So this is quite a pretty romantic week for you, turning out to be for you. You will be showered with a lot of love and attention in this week. Professionally, not a good time to take up any new project or start up a new project. Otherwise, don't tell me that I hadn't want you on that. Avoid business trips completely. Trips otherwise, travels otherwise will be successful, but business trips I would want you to avoid. So keep that in mind. Financially, it's an average week. Nothing great happening, nothing bad either. Health-wise, you need to be careful. Too much of a travel can take a toll on your health. And in family matters, you're going to be very, very focused as far as your family is concerned. And the whole interest would turn into their protection, their needs, and all their happiness and success. By the end of the week, there are new beginnings that are taking shape. Beautiful time and beautiful energies falling in. And good growth period taking shape for you. The card that came for you is the listening card, which means that you need to awaken your inner intuitive streaks and energies and listen to what your guardian angels are wanting to tell you, what others are trying to tell you, whether it is your relationship area, whether it is your work area. There are people trying to communicate to you and yet you are not, you've closed yourself up. You need to open up, listen to them. Maybe somewhere, some down the line, somebody is trying to give you a message which would be really, really good for you. So awaken your intuitive streaks, follow what your guardian angels are wanting to tell you, and this will be a beautiful time and phase to enjoy those energies. Beautiful time again to manifest positive energies in your life. Things are growing beautifully and they would turn out beautifully for you too. I would pray for that. A lot of energies happening around 12, 13, 14 that had happened in the last week, which would start manifesting from this week onwards. Again, a lot of good time frame to develop positive affirmations and build up new energy zones for you and take up new initiatives and new actions and decide upon what you want to do in your life. So I pray for you all and I wish you all a beautiful week ahead and may God bless you in all your endeavors. I'll come back again. Do subscribe my channel. There's a red subscription box down there. Click on that and you'll be subscribed and I'll keep posting a lot of celestial updates that I do. Mercury has gone direct and Saturn is about to change its side. What impact it would have, we'll definitely come up with that. If you have any queries, please post me your queries in my email ID. My email ID is soch.345@gmail.com. soch.345@gmail.com. Please do mail me your queries there. We would, and I do look into all your queries and they're based on energy exchange. Do drop in a message or comment and like the button there if you like the videos. And I would definitely want to reinvent or do more videos as per your liking. Stay blessed and God bless you. Aatma Namaste.